Good morning, dear students. We are learning lesson from chemistry, that is third lesson, that is metals and non-metals. So, what happens when metal becomes acid? What happens means we have seen simply all the physical properties of metals as well as some chemical properties of metals. As well as what happens when metal and non-metal react with each other. When they combine, what forms? Yes, what forms? Can you guess? When metal and non-metal combine with each other, what forms? Yes, correct. Ionic compounds and radic forms. There are two kinds of compounds. Ionic compound and covalent compound. Covalent compound, we will be learning in lesson number 4, that is chemistry of carbon compound and carbon and its compound. In that lesson, we are going to learn the covalent compound. But here, I let you know about ionic compound, which are formed by the combination of metal and the non-metal, right? Electron donation and electron acceptance. Because of it, the ionic compounds are formed, I have said you. And as well as I have told you some, with the example, how sodium chloride has formed, how magnesium chloride has formed, how magnesium oxide has formed. So, ionic compound is also said to be electrovalent compound. There is one term. That term is electrovalent compound. Ionic compound is also said to be electrovalent compound. Why is it said to be electrovalent compound? Can you guess? Electrovalent compound, why it is said to be correct? Because electrovalent in this ionic compound, electrons are either accepted or electrons are either donated. Metals are always electropositive in nature. Because metals are always electron donating, while non-metals are always accepting electrons, and so that ionic compounds are formed. Ionic compounds means what? They are having a charge on it. Metals are always cation, while non-metals are always anion. See here, this I would like to remind you. NaCl, Na, sodium is always giving 1, so it forms a plus charge. Like Cl is always accepting, so it is having a NaCl. So NaCl is the electrovalent compound or the ionic compound. So now we will explain just some properties of this, some physical properties of this ionic compounds. So have you ever seen some ionic compounds? Salts, all salts are ionic compounds. But in our day-to-day life, the salt which we use, that is common salt, NaCl. This is my written here the chemical formula of it. So NaCl is a common salt, okay, which is used in various products. It is used slowly, slowly. We come from where it is exactly used. In next topic, we will see where this salt is used. So this is the common salt which adds the taste in our food. So most of the salts are ionic compounds, and you have seen the structure of salt. Actually, which we are using in the powdery form, powder in the crystalline form, which we use the salt, that is not actually salt, actually the we can say the crystals of salts are present. Then we grind them and we convert them into the crystalline form. But actually, the salts, maybe rock salt or the sea salt, is actually in the form of crystals. So, the first property of this ionic compound is that ionic compounds are mostly in solid state. In their state, there are three states, solid, liquid and gas. So, the state of the ionic compound is mostly solid. So, the first property is ionic compounds are solid in state. Solid state means they have more density. Density word is common for you. Density, more dense. So they have more dense because they are combined together by negative and positive. So ionic compounds are solid in state. They have more density because positive cations and anions combine together to form give them a solid shape. So, second property of ionic compound is, which is quite related to the first property, ionic compounds have high melting compounds, maids and boys at very high temperature. What might be the reason behind it? Because these are formed by cations and anions. So the force of attraction between them is very, very strong. Do you get students? They are formed by the cations and anions. And so that as they have different charges, the attraction between them is very strong. And to break these bonds, electrovalent bond are formed. To break this bond, a large amount of energy is required in the form of heat. And we are providing them heat by increasing temperature. And so that ionic compounds have very much high melting and boiling point. Means at very high temperature they melt, and at very low, at very high temperature they boil too. So this is the second most important property of ionic compound, is ionic compounds have a high melting and boiling point. You can give example in your textbook, 4 or 5 examples are given, so you can refer them and write in the exam. Now third property of ionic compound is, most of the ionic compounds, or mostly ionic compounds, can dissolve into the water to form an aqueous solution of that particular salt. Suppose NaCl, common salt, if you take and if you try to dissolve it into the water, then it forms a solution of salt. Okay, but ionic compounds, but these are not soluble in solvents such as petrol and kerosene. Means if you will try to dissolve salts into the petrol and kerosene, these are not soluble into the petrol and kerosene. These ionic compounds or salts are soluble only and only into the water, but not in petrol and kerosene. Ionic compounds are soluble. Soluble means we can dissolve them into the water. Are soluble into the water, but we are insoluble in solvents such as kerosene and petrol. Now there are four properties. Now fourth property is BBD, which is quite interesting to know. As we are knowing, there are some salt solution which can conduct electricity. We have already conduction of electricity is taking place. For conduction of electricity, we require some ions, positive and negative ions we require to flow them or to conduct them, we require. So this ionic compound contains ion as a anion and cation, because this contains, and so that ionic compounds are very good conductors of heat and electricity. So this is the fourth property, because ionic compounds are made up of cations and anion. It's a combination of cations and anions, so that ionic compounds are very good conductors of heat and electricity. Means through their solution, we can conduct electricity. So, fourth property is, ionic compounds are good conductors of electricity. So here I will finish this topic, that is properties of ionic compound. That is, ionic compounds are solid in state. Ionic compounds have a high melting and boiling point. Ionic compounds are soluble into the water, but these are insoluble into the solids such as kerosene and petrol. And fourth important property is, ionic compounds are good conductors of electricity. Thank you, students. Tomorrow we will go for the